A very good afternoon to all the dignitaries present on and off the dais, and to my fellow student managers. I, Rahul Chaudhary, student of Sri Balaji Society, is feeling privileged to introduce you all the prominent personality amongst us, Mr. Anand Agarwal, Director of Finance at Amazon India. Anand sir has 18 years of experience as a finance professional in the FMCG, chemical and e-commerce industry. He has diverse experience in wide range of finance disciplines including business partnering, accounting, financial planning and analysis, treasury, taxation, risk management, internal control and compliances, forensic audits, strategy development and deployment, investor relations and shared service. In his current role, he is in the center of India's hottest industry and a senior leader at Amazon India. With applause, may I now invite sir to share his experience and knowledge.
So I have worked with India's leading company, right? Britannia is a biscuit major, all of us know it's a bakery leader in India. I also worked with Syngenta, which is a Pune-based company. So it was a nostalgic for me to come back to Pune after a year, and I joined Amazon last year in September. Agile organization, I think that's the topic for today. Can someone tell me what does agile organization mean? More aware about its environment, right?
Step by step.
Proactive approach, right? Which is not rigid, okay? Adaptive to changes. Responsive. And why do we need an agile organization?
Hierarchy, sir.
For survival. That's a good one. Who said for survival? That's a good one. What else? Growth. But why is it important? Why do we need to be agile? Sorry? Technology? Okay. What else? Only technology? Consumer demand, that's a good one. I'll show you a video on the consumer demand. Sustainability, yeah, that's right. So, agile organization is important because the rapid changes in four fronts: technology, competition, regulation, and demand. It is also getting more because of complex and volatile business environment. And I'll cover each one of them in my presentation. And in the later half of the presentation, I'll cover how at Amazon we are working for being an agile organization. Right? All of you know this? What happened? What happened to Nokia? Right? 5 years back, Nokia was a market leader, right? Where are they today? So the technology changes, right? They didn't realize that the smartphone is going to become the future of the India, the future of the world. And they didn't invent or they didn't innovate. So Nokia is no more. How about Kodak? Right? Only the name is there. So technology creates a disruption, and if an organization is not agile, right, we have seen the fate of large organizations which have faced this problem. Let's come to the next one. Competition. Right? Why is competition agility critical for handling competition? Because you can have an incumbent versus insurgent. Does it sound familiar to you? Insurgent? To one person it sounds familiar, looks like. So what does an insurgent does? An insurgent brings a disruption, right? It brings
It represents choice and change. It sets an example of bold initiative. It targets opportunity and creates bias for action. So can you give me an example of insurgent? Huh? Reliance Jio, yes, it has caused disruption. What else? Food Panda, yes. Uber, Ola, Oyo. So I have also got a list of insurgents. First one is Amazon. So when people were okay buying, going to a retail store and buying, Amazon introduced this concept of delivering at home. Right? So that's a disruption. Apple, how many of you remember the Walkman? How many of you use a Walkman? Walkman, not iPod. Sony Walkman. Right? Sorry? We used to use, not now. Why is Amitabh Bachchan an insurgent? Because of? So when Amitabh Bachchan came into film industry, right, who were ruling the roast that time? The romantic heroes. And he came with an angry young man. So he created that disruption. So if you have to handle competition, right, you have to be agile. Because competition comes and creates a disruption. And if you are not agile, we will become like Nokia or Kodak. Regulation. All of us can relate to it. Right? Demonetization. One fine day evening, Prime Minister says, currency is not acceptable. Right? And the companies which operate on cash and carry. So I come from Britannia, where we operate on advance payment. Suddenly there is no cash in the trade. What will we do? Remember, if you don't sell for 1 month, you are losing 12% growth. Can you afford? So regulation is another area where the agility has to be there. GST, right? We are hearing the news every day. So the organization needs to be agile to handle the regulatory changes. If you are not agile, you will face a serious problem in the business. Demand. I said I will play a video, right? So why is demand important? But why do you need agility for the demand? Sorry? This side is very silent. I can't hear anything from that side. Why is demand important? Main driving force. Someone from the back, why is demand important? Why is demand important? There are a lot of emerging consumer needs, right? If you need your organization to be sustainable, if you need your organization to grow, you have to address the consumer needs. So I'll play a video, have a look.
4 years ago, we started to wonder, what would shopping look like if you could walk into a store, grab what you want, and just go? What if we could weave the most advanced machine learning, computer vision, and AI into the very fabric of a store so you never have to wait in line? No lines, no checkouts, no registers. Welcome to Amazon Go. Use the Amazon Go app to enter. Then put away your phone and start shopping. It's really that simple. Take whatever you like. Anything you pick up is automatically added to your virtual cart. If you change your mind about that cupcake, just put it back. Our technology will update your virtual cart automatically. So, how does it work? We used computer vision, deep learning algorithms, and sensor fusion, much like you'd find in self-driving cars. We call it Just Walk Out technology. Once you've got everything you want, you can just go. When you leave, our Just Walk Out technology adds up your virtual card and charges your Amazon account. Your receipt is sent straight to the app, and you can keep going. Amazon Go. No lines, no checkout. No, seriously.
Okay, what is the need we were trying to address? What was the demand we were trying to address? Sorry? No lines, right? What is most frustrating when we go and buy grocery in a superstore? Queues. Right? So that's the agility. So we at Amazon thought through it, and I was in US last month. I went to this store and the experience is exactly like what they're showing in the video. You just go in, pick up whatever you want and come out of that store. Is it amazing? So that's how the agility of the organization is. Which is the world's oldest company? Some company called Kongo Gumi in Japan, right? Not relevant. See the context. So it went into liquidation in 2006. None of us knew the name of that company. Did we know the name of that company? No. Which is the world's most valued company? Apple, Walmart, right? I hear Apple more. Is that right? Okay. So what does agile organization do? It has got ability to quickly reconfigure strategy, structure, processes, people and technology. But there's a very critical thing which they do. If an organization does all these five things, is it an agile organization? Yes, no. What is missing from here? What is missing from here? Innovation, what else? You just now answered, right? It does not matter how old a company is. It's matter if you are a valuable company. So the agile organization needs to have all these towards value creating and value protecting opportunities. Because if you restructure your strategy, if you reorganize your strategy, but it does not go towards value creation or value protecting, we will become like the oldest company in the world. Is this clear? So now I'll come to Amazon. How do we at Amazon drive agility? So our vision is we want to be the Earth's most customer-centric company. That's the vision for Amazon. Our mission is we'll transform the way India buys, we'll transform the way India sells, and in doing so, we'll transform India itself. Right? Huge opportunity for us. In such a big GDP, retail is a very small portion of the entire pie, and e-commerce is even a very, very small pie of that. How many of you can relate to this? So what does this mean? A potter doing a pottery, what does it mean for the commerce? Anyone? Sorry? Manual work. What else? Shaping, okay. So this is an example of how technology can help, right? If you look at a potter who is in a village, the e-commerce helps them to connect to a larger group, right? He can sell his product across India. That's how the commerce is changing. You can see the dash button on the side, the tide. You don't have to go log into your account. You don't have to see what is the price. You can subscribe for that. You just press this button and the product will be delivered to your home. Look at the convenience. That's the app, Amazon app through which you can buy. There's an Eco. Eco is the latest launch we have done in India. It is there worldwide. You can speak an order. Right? Yes. E-wallet. Almost all of us must be using Paytm now. Amazon has also got Amazon Pay. Right? So, the wallet is changing into a digital wallet from the physical currency. And the shopping. This is our launch when we did in India. Right? So, all the team members when we launched in India were there in one room. And now we are all, you know, fighting for the space in that building. And we have got n number of floors, I don't know how many. So that's how big we have grown in India. This is our basic core which drives us, right? This is called Amazon Flywheel. Can anyone tell me what does it mean? Lot of circles is what I can see. So let me take a minute to explain to you. This means if you have got a right selection on your platform, when I say selection is the variety of products on the platform, on the marketplace, we will create a good customer experience. If you create a good customer experience, more and more people will come and buy, which is the traffic. More and more people coming to buy from us, more the sellers will like to sell on our platform. More the sellers will sell on our platform, the selection will go up, right? And what will happen? Customer experience will become better and we'll get more growth. Once we get more growth, cost structure will be lower. So we'll be able to offer lower prices to our customers. And the customer experience will improve. So this is a flywheel we use in Amazon for decision making. This is one of the very critical parameters for us when we operate in Amazon. That how do we make our flywheel spin? So your margin is my opportunity. That's the way we operate, right? If there's a margin, there's an opportunity to operate. One of the questions which people ask Amazon, how do you build a large tech organization that is wired, right? Which works together. And we work on one very simple principle. We work customer backwards. We think from the lens of the customer. And we strive to act like a startup despite being 100 billion plus in revenue, $100 billion plus in revenue. Right? That's how we work together. And I'll show you the examples, how do we operate customer backward. Right? The entire Amazon works on 14 leadership principles. So what you see in bold is unique and peculiar to Amazon. Right? Others you can find at other places, but what you see in bold, whether it's customer obsession, invent and simplify, have backbone, disagree and commit, bias for action, vocally self-critical, dive deep. So what does it mean? What does have backbone, disagree and commit mean? If you feel something is wrong, you should say. So have backbone is in Amazon, irrespective of what level you are, you can respectfully disagree with a particular point and you can place your point in front of the panel where the discussion is happening, irrespective of the hierarchy to which you belong. That's called have backbone. You can challenge a person who may be a vice president of the organization. You can challenge him, right? It's well accepted in Amazon. But once you agree, right, you have to commit. So as a finance professional, lot of time we have got a business decision making, right? And sometime I may say, I don't agree to it. But business will say, no, we want to try it out. So my standard response at that time is, I disagree but commit. And once we commit, we are part of the decision. What does vocally self-critical means? So in Amazon, it is okay to say that I have made a mistake. And we accept the bad news very, very, without any, you know, concern on that with the person who is bringing that news. So, and we encourage leaders in Amazon to come and say, okay, I've got this problem, but I don't know the solution. It's quite right in Amazon to give a bad news and also quite right to say, I don't have a solution for that. So So how do we generate ideas, right? And how do we use the idea? So suppose I have to launch that dash button which we saw in the previous slide, we will prepare a press release for it at the idea stage, which says, what will a customer say when this product gets launched? So when launching the dash button or when launching Alexa, what will a customer say? What need of customer are we addressing? We start from there. We call it PR FAQ. So all our new initiatives are through press release. We also write what are the frequently asked questions which a customer can ask and what an internal stakeholder will ask. So all our new initiatives are customer backward. We think from the lens of customer. So brick and mortar business model versus e-commerce business model. So we call it transaction economics versus relationship economics. Transaction is at a particular transaction, right? One time you sell a product, you make a margin, that's all. Relationship is over a period of time, you have a multiple transaction with the customer. So the e-commerce also operates in that way. So you acquire a customer, the cost of acquisition may be high, but over a period of time, right? So you look at a long-term benefit and not a short-term benefit. You don't look at a per product margin what you make. You look at over a period of time, what is the cash flow you will do make from that customer? This is the quote from the letter which Jeff has written to the shareholder in 1997. Right? We said, when forced to choose between optimizing the appearance of our gap accounting and maximizing the present value of future cash flow, we will take the cash flow. So is it clear to all of you? Transaction economics versus the relationship economics. So you have to take a long-term view, right? Gap accounting is how much money do you make in a particular year? Cash, future cash flow is how much money we are going to earn on a long-term basis. We are obsessed with measurement. So Amazon is a metric-driven organization. We are obsessed with measurement. And let me tell you one thing. I have been with Amazon now for 13 months. This is only the second time I am doing a PowerPoint presentation. I did once at a gathering and this is the second time I am doing it. In Amazon, we don't use PowerPoint presentation because we are obsessed with measurement. All our reviews in Amazon, we do it with a 6-page document, right? We write down all the narratives. We supplement it with the data. It makes us agile. It makes us to think in the right direction. So all decisions then become a more data-based and an informed decision. There are two moments of truth in an e-commerce company. One is making the purchase, another is making the delivery. How many of you think after you have made a purchase, it should come to you next moment? Right? Lot of you. In fact, my vision was, moment I say, they say order placed, someone should ring my doorbell and say, sir, this is your package. Right? And I think a day will come when this will also happen. Right? We have got a 2-hour delivery service now, but that's how we think. So how do we make it more convenient for a customer to make a purchase, and how do we make a good delivery experience for a customer? And that has been our endeavor in Amazon. In the e-commerce industry, execution is the key. Do we agree? Do we agree? So when your page, how many of you use the Amazon app? Lot of you. If it takes 2 seconds to load that page, how do you feel? Irritated, right? And what do you think money it would have cost to us by that few seconds of page loading getting delayed? Can you guess how much money will it cost to us? So this is a study. X millisecond faster page load is proven to improve sales by 0.5%. $100 billion, how much is 0.5%? 500 million. Lot of company does not have a turnover of $500 million, right? So X millisecond faster page load is proven to improve sales by 0.5%. Right? So execution is such a key for us. So we try to work to see how does our app is more faster. The other hypothesis, the difference between the number one player and number two player is just 2% better execution. So I was attending one of the seminar and I liked when the speaker said, what is water at 99 degrees centigrade? Have you heard of this? What is water at 99 degrees centigrade? 99 degrees centigrade. What is it 100 degrees centigrade? What do you call it? Steam, right? What can we do with steam? So 1 degree difference, right, creates a huge difference. That one extra degree. At 99 degree, you are still a water. At 100 degree, you are steam, right, which gets converted into electricity. There are multiple usage of that. Similarly, in e-commerce, even a 2% better execution can result in huge difference. Over the time, the 2% better execution gets compounded into double the size. And that's the key for execution for us. If you are not agile, we are gone. How many of you know machine learning? Right, the buzzword today. How many of you know of machine learning? Very few of you. Some of you, okay. We in Amazon use machine learning to a greater extent. And when I share the example, you'll be able to relate. How do we use in your parlance? So what is the machine learning? In the typical computing, we give input. This is a program. What does it give? Output. In a machine learning, what do? We feed both in input and output to a program. The program becomes better and better in prediction because it is able to see the correlation between the earlier input and output. So the program improves over a period of time. Right? And that's what the machine learning is all about. How many of you are familiar with this? So when you go and log in Amazon app, right? Does it tell you what you bought earlier, right? None of you see a common screen, right? If you bought a shirt, it will show you different shirts, right? If you bought a book, it will show you different books. How does it happen? It's all machine learning, right? Because we have got so many customers, no one can manually do it. So it picks up from your behavior, it picks up from your trend, and it shows you what you want. Right? Now, when you go to Google also, if you are traveling somewhere, it will tell you your flight is at so and so time. Right? It's all machine learning. We are also obsessed in Amazon on tools. How do we adopt tool? And how do we inspect the outcome of the tool? So, invent and simplify was one of our leadership principles. We use it extensively in getting the tools. So mechanisms are assembled from organization level. So when we introduce a tool, right, first we think what are the tools we can introduce to simplify the ways of working. Once we decide that, we track when are we implementing. Once we implement the tool, we don't go and start auditing the result. We first audit the adoption. What do you mean by adoption? Can't hear from the last few people. What do you mean by adoption? Sorry? Yeah. So adoption is how many people are using it. If there are 100 people who are supposed to use and only 5 people are using it, we say 5% adoption. So the first goal we take at Amazon is to drive adoption before we go and start auditing the results. Once we cross adoption, we start auditing the results. Managing complexity. Do you think Amazon is a complex organization? Yes, no. So yes, we are a tech company. Have you heard of this? Even without drones, we are a tech company. Right? And let me tell you why. Have you ever thought, how do we handle pricing? 10 crores product, can anyone do a pricing? Can anyone do a manual pricing for 10 crore products? Do you think price changes every minute? How does it happen? Right? It's all driven by the machine. There's an algorithm which works. It's not only demand supply. There are a lot of algorithms which works to decide the pricing on the marketplace. Right? So there are two kinds of company. Those which work to charge more and those that work to charge less. We will be the second one. So if you look at our pricing, you'll find it to be lesser. Right? And that's what our principle of operation has been. Coming to agility, leaders in the future will spend 50% of their time managing people. Another 50% of their time spent on managing machines. And that's how technology is changing. Right? All of us agree? We see our customers as invited guests to a party and we are the host. It's our job every day to make every important aspect of the customer experience a little bit better. So customer is at the center of all our decision making. For all our initiatives, customer is at the core. Aware of this going on right now? So there were two times in 2014 and 2016, right, when the orders crossed our expectation. Good thing or a bad thing? What should we do when order crosses our expectation? Fulfill them. Right? But we disagree with you. Yeah, that's right. But what should we do at that moment of time? That time we withdraw the offer. Because we don't want customer experience to suffer. We don't want customer trust to be broken. So when we got orders beyond the capacity which we could have fulfilled, we withdrew the offer. Right? If our delivery person cannot deliver you on the day one what is promised, right, that promise will be withdrawn. Because to us, sales is not important. What is important is the customer trust and customer experience. And that's what we think long term. The concept of one-way door. So it's in context of decision making. So when we take decision in Amazon, the first thing we ask, is it reversible decision? It is irreversible decision. If it is a reversible decision, we call it a two-way door. That means I can go out and come back. So our speed of response in that case has to be quick, right? Because I can reverse that decision. In Amazon, we promote risk-taking ability. We say if it's a two-way decision, don't do more data analytics, right? Take decision fast. If it is one-way door, then be cautious. Customer trust again comes as a guiding factor. Will it help you in one-way and two-way door decision making? In your career, remember, when it's a two-way door, the speed of response will be very fast. If it is one-way door, then think twice. Because once you have made that decision, you can't revert. So if you have broken a customer promise, it's very difficult to retrieve it back. So most decisions are two-way doors and are reversible. What's difficult to reverse is loss of customer trust. We will make bold rather than timid investment decisions where we see a sufficient probability of gaining market leadership advantage. So Amazon always bets big wherever there's an opportunity to take a market leadership advantage. Some of them will pay off, some of them may not. but we are not shy of taking a bold decision. And we have learned another valuable lesson in either case, whether we succeed or don't succeed. So this was the quote which was given to our team when we launched India. It says, in India, fire, fire, and then better than. What does it mean? This means speed of response has to be faster, right? Don't worry on the accuracy. Go ahead and implement. If it is two-way door decision, please go ahead and implement. We can learn and correct it, instead of waiting to have more accurate data and deciding basis that. That was the brief to India team. So we'll continue to make investment decision in light of long-term market leadership consideration rather than short-term profitability consideration or short-term Wall Street reactions. So it's fire, fire, and then aim, rather than aim, aim, and then fire. Have you seen of this? Drone going to moon for delivery of package. Amazon, we still believe it is a day one for us, because we still think we are at a very, very early stage of our evolution. So it's a day one at Amazon. So we're transforming the way India buys and sells. So that's all from my side.
So today in e-commerce, when we say it is a rapid changing market and an industry which is growing day by day, and there are the companies who are coming out new ways to capture more and more market. So what are your views about ambush advertisement? Like you counter the advertisement of the opponent.
So but Amazon does not believe in. So if you look at our leadership principle, right, and I'll answer a lot of my questions through my leadership principle. Our leadership principle is customer obsession. So we look at competition, but we are all focused on customer. So if you look at all our advertisement, we call it Great India Sale. We don't go and say anything which is counter to our competition. You can take any of our ads, right? None of them are counter to any of the competition. Because all our ads are to our customers, not to the competition.
Sir, this is Karthik Pandey from BIIB Marketing. So my question to you is, sir, what's your take on the current condition of online retail in India, and in relevance with the government policies that they have with the marketplace model and the inventory model, since the last 8 years, the market penetration has only been 2.56% of the total retail industry in India for the e-commerce sector. And what all you expect further? As far as the government, isn't there be any more flexibility that should be given to the online retailing?
So, you know, you have to operate within the given environment in which you operate. If government has got a certain regulation, all of us have to work within that regulation. I think you yourself has given a data point. It is 2.5%, right, as per you? So another 97.5% is still open. So we see this as a big opportunity for us. And that's what the agility, the topic of our discussion today, agility. How agile are we to work in that environment? So to me, I see this as a big opportunity. As per your data point, 97.5% is still open for the e-commerce to look at.
And so one more question, sir. What's the exact motive behind this project Udaan?
Again, Udaan is a customer-centric initiative, right? Do you know what Udaan is all about?
It's can you more
tell
like
what is it about?
About reaching to the remote areas of India by being the brick and mortar store concept.
So person can visit to a brick and mortar store and place the order with the help of the shopkeeper of that store. So we are enabling a person who may not have access to the internet and a smartphone to still transact on e-commerce and have the benefit of the e-commerce. So as I said, we'll transform the way India buys, the way India sells.
Thank you, sir.
So while studying, sir, like when FDIs were coming to India in single brand retail and the multi-brand retail, sir, what point came up that in Indian rural markets, sir, the small credit we get from the baniyas and baniyas at the nearby shop, so they are the main driving force that why these malls are not that successful in India. So, sir, is Amazon considering that point as well, sir?
Saying credit, you're talking about credit. Is that what your question?
Yes.
So, how many of you have seen a EMI offer on our website? How many of you have seen a no-cost EMI? So, the marketplace is also offering currently a no-cost EMI. So, Baniya's offer, when you are calling Baniya, is talking about the lower end segment. If you come to Amazon, right, you will find a lot of products which on which there is a no-cost EMI. That means you are extending the credit without charging interest to the customer. Did you hear of a EMI holiday in our last EMI holiday? Sale a week back, we had a EMI holiday. You heard about it? So, we are also offering a EMI holiday in our last festival program. That is, if you buy now, you have to pay after 3 months.
Thank you, sir, for such an interactive session on agile organizations and giving us a brief insight about Amazon, as it makes us all understand the working of it. Thank you once again, sir, for enlightening us with your words of wisdom.